fuor di città presso l'Arno una sera di primavera. Vidi sull'aia d'un casolare parecchie coppie a ballare. M'avvicinai ai vedemmi, mi fanno venite, venite avanti. Sapete qua, ma noi non si sa ricevere come in città. Gli ei valse della povera gente, gli un semplice varsere fatto di niente. Con due chitarre e un organino si ballanzino ai mattino.
Hello everybody! Today I would like to welcome you to a new series of videos that I hope to continue also in the future. And it's going to be about me landscape painting and traveling to different spots, different places. Right now we're still under restrictions here in Tuscany, but I'm allowed to leave my house, I'm allowed to move around the region. And I immediately took the occasion and went to the north of Tuscany to a region that is called the Versilia. The Versilia is close to Liguria and it's between the seaside and the mountains. The mountains are called the Alpi Apuane and they're mainly famous in that area for their marble. This area is also very beautiful in the aspect of nature. It's very particular because you got the seaside in front of you and the mountains in the background. And even if it's hot summertime, you look back at the mountain scene and it seems like they got snow on them. They are white from the marble of the Carrara region. Carrara is the most famous town for its marble there, and that's where the most marble quarries are. Right now I'm on 900 meters above sea level and unexpectedly it's really hot and I probably got the worst sunburn of my life. I should have known better because the white of the marble is very, very reflective. In fact, the Italian word marmo comes from the Greek origin and means the stone that is reflective. One of the challenges in landscape painting, in fact, is that you want to be prepared for any possible scenario that might happen while you're out there. So you got to bring the mosquito spray, the sunscreen, the sunglasses, a hat, plenty of water, anything that you might need physically for yourself. And of course, you need the landscape easel, you need brushes, the mediums, the paints, the palette knives, and all the equipment you need for your painting. It's a little bit hard to find the balance in the beginning because obviously you want to be having everything that you need. But at the same time, you also want to carry as little as possible with you. Otherwise, a lot of the places that are beautiful for landscape painting are hard to access. And you do not want to be hiking up in the mountains with a lot of luggage on your back. And it makes the journey much harder than it should be. The afternoon that I arrived in the area, I took the time to scout some of the locations that friends and people living in the area were recommending to me. The one spot I was immediately struck by its beauty and by its uniqueness, is the Ponte di Vara. These bridges were built by the end of the 18th century as a means to transport the marble down the mountains. First they were used by trains, now they are transformed into roads. Everything that you see is handmade, man-built. The steep roads, the bridges and the tunnels that are leading through the mountains. Also the caves, the marble caves, have been there since the Roman times. Everything was done back then by slaves trying to get the mountain, trying to get the stone out from the mountain. Nowadays we have modern techniques and better technologies to do that, but it still remains a very, very dangerous job to do in order to get that precious stone. This is only the first appointment for my little painting trip around the Carrara area. So please stay tuned. There's going to be more settings, there's going to be more locations, and I'm going to be telling you a little bit more about the history and the culture of this place.